everybody. David here from Markzware. As many of you know, we've been fixing a lot of bad Adobe InDesign files, as well as Quark files, but we have a tool for doing the Quark files. And for InDesign, we've been offering a service to fix them. There's one thing I always like to recommend to people about these bad files, because a lot of times the corruption doesn't happen all at one time with a crash or something. It might happen over time, a corrupted font, corrupted image, or something inside that file that just isn't jiving right with InDesign, CS3, CS4, even CS2. So a very important tip is when you're in InDesign, which we're going to pop into now, I have CS3 primarily running on this machine, is to, when you open a file, let's open one I just fixed here. This was a file that it's crashing InDesign, even crashed Quark when I used the ID to Q, InDesign to Quark conversion filter to fix the files. So what you basically do is you take the file, and let's zoom in a bit here, and you do a file export in InDesign, and you'll get this window. And what you want to do is export it using the Adobe InDesign Interchange file format. There's all different options. You can export XML, even JPEG, PDF, of course. But if you take this file, export as InDesign Interchange, or a .INX, as you see here, and if we do that, you see the document export. What happens, close this file, so what happens, we get the file here, we get the file, it's a .inx, and this allows it to open in different versions of InDesign. You can open this now in CS3, CS4, or even CS2, I believe. But what this also does is if we drop it on InDesign, is it basically scrubs the file. And you see now it's re-linking everything here. And you see it's very busy with sort of recreating this file. It basically scrubs, will basically scrub the file and make it less likely to be corrupted than it was before. So this is a tip that a lot of the InDesign professionals out there, users who use it every day out in the field will give, is to use the Adobe Interchange format when you have any oddities going on in your InDesign file to make sure you try to scrub that file by just simply exporting it. That might solve a lot of your bad files that some of you are getting out there with InDesign. That's it. Just wanted to share that with you, how to file export an InDesign file to the Adobe Interchange file to help scrub it. Thank you. David signing off. Yeah.